is already a very strong relationship between people and technology. I think back to a family moment where one of my kids walked up to the television screen as a toddler and tried to turn the channel by simply scrolling right. Technology is a partner, it's something that they've grown up with. It's their everyday. Whereas certainly in my generation, this is something I suppose that we challenge ourselves, but we have that mindset to learn and continue thinking about how we can use technology to enable our everyday lives. DeepL, as a purpose-led company, we are here to break down language barriers. That means our employees can really connect the work that they do to the impact that that has in the world. We're very fortunate to work with so many people with different backgrounds. What this does is actually enriches our culture even more by those different experiences, those different cultural nuances that people talk about every day. Whether this is on a Zoom, whether it's the experiences and the conversations that we might have in the corridor, it truly is enlightening. And it also gives you energy and drives more innovation in some of the work that we're actually doing.
When I first joined the DeepL research team, I had the impression that it was a group of very talented and smart people, and they had access to a large compute infrastructure equipped with the latest GPUs from NVIDIA. And all of this together allows the research team to come up with creative solutions to the problems we face in translation. When I started, I had good knowledge about AI and NLP, but over the time, I had to acquire a lot of knowledge about translation and which problems we face as a company, translating and stepping up to the needs of our users. DeepL fosters a culture of trust, which means that it allows all their employees to solve the tasks they have the way they want, and there's not much micromanagement going on. DeepL as a company creates a lot of possibilities to grow personally. We have dedicated learning budgets which we can spend on growing as a person, doing courses, buying books, which means that I personally have the feeling that I can grow not only professionally but also personally here at DeepL.
The biggest challenge is that AI can understand the context of a message and also understand the nuances and different layers that is inside this human message. Now we can rely on AI to advise us or to understand us and create new material from this. How do I create a safe space for my team to solve these challenges and succeed? I acknowledge that this is a complex challenge that we are solving. We understand that this comes with a lot of human feelings, of fear, of anxieties, but being there, being vulnerable, making sure that they have the right tools to solve this challenge and the right guidance, this is all part of this process. Failing and trying new things is not bad. This is one step forward to solving the challenge.
DeepL has a strong culture in ownership and collaboration. And what this does is it helps us then build products with real life in mind. What I mean is that we put people at the center of everything we're building. So really thinking about those real life experiences and then therefore what does the technology do to solve those experiences? We sometimes call it built for people by people.
The research team builds translation models which are able to translate into different many languages which we are at the research team don't know or not able to speak. So we are need to collaborate with a language experts here at DeepL to ensure that the quality of these translation models is perfect. And this is one prime example that collaboration between research and language is crucial for a good outcome of the project.
People care so much about the product that they send us feedback. And most of the times it's congratulating us. So, of course, this is a way of measuring this success. People take time to tell us that we managed to do something right.
I really hope that my work makes a difference for everyone or someone each day. Otherwise, I just don't think I would want to show up. I think it goes back to purpose. Particularly as having three kids, I've always wanted to make sure that my work isn't just about my income. It's about how I can impact others. And in fact, I think it rang true one day for me. My daughter, I think, was 8. She asked me, "So, Mummy, what do you do each day?" And it's really hard trying to explain, as the people function was called in those days, human resources. And I essentially said to her, "Actually, I make people happy." So reflecting on that, I really do hope I make people happy. If I think about how we hire them, how we pay them, how we develop them, and how we grow them. I truly believe that AI will never replace human value. I see AI as just another technical wave that we're riding. And believe me, I've seen a few of these. The opportunity that we have with AI is that we can really unlock human value, meaning that administrative, meaningless tasks that are bureaucratic can be removed. And that allows us then to really unlock our potential as employees, as people in the work that we're doing. The work that we can do can be more strategic, can be more elevated, which then benefits not just ourselves in our personal development, but also benefits businesses as well as benefiting our customers alike.
If I could teach AI one thing, it probably would be empathy. And if we can be sure that AI is always working in our favor, I think this helps us to establish a bright future.